Hello, my lovely friends. My name is Ava, and today I am so excited to talk to you about some friends to lovers romance recommendations. If you didn't know, I am a huge friends to lovers fan. I love it more than enemies to lovers. I'm one of those girlies. So I have a few recommendations for this trope. I will link them both down below if you would like to watch more recommendations. So I have 10 more for you today, so let's get started. First, we have Dad Bod Wingman by Carla Doyle. This is actually a childhood friends to lovers romance that I thought was so freaking cute. But don't let the cuteness fool you, because it gets very hot. So Jensen and Bailey are childhood friends that have honestly always been pining after each other. Jensen finally moves back home to his small town and he ends up running into his bestie Bailey. At the beginning, he finally gets enough courage to ask her out and she immediately says yes, and he's like shocked. He's like, oh my gosh, she actually said yes to me? Like, he's so surprised but also thrilled that like the woman of his dreams would say yes to him asking her out. But he has no clue that Bailey has also been pining after him. This was just so sweet and so cute. Like, just a 100-page novella, I want to say, right? That was just like so amazing. Like, I love the friends to lovers aspect in here and how you could see that they really progressed throughout the years. Next, I have People We Meet on Vacation by Emily Henry. I feel like this is a staple friends to lovers romance. This one is about Poppy and Alex, and they were best friends in college. They met in college, I think in one of their classes, and they became best friends, like best friends. They did everything together. They would go on vacations with each other all the time. But that was then, when they were in college. This book jumps back and forth between then time when they were best friends and present time when they do not speak or talk to each other at all. Poppy ends up, I think, going to a wedding, and she decides to go out on a limb and ask Alex to go on one last vacation with her, even though they haven't spoken in quite a long time. She really wants to have her best friend back. And so throughout the book, you're trying to realize, oh, how did they not become friends anymore? What happened? And like, you slowly realize throughout the book, like, what happened between the two of them. But I really did enjoy this friends to lovers, and that's probably my favorite part of this book, was when they were friends and like their old friend chapters, because they were so funny and fun, and it looked like they were having a great time. And I mean, I got to see the slow progression from friends to lovers, and I really enjoyed reading that. Next, I have Like You Love Me by Adriana Locke. This is such a sweet and cute small town romance that I just ate up. This is the romance between Holden and Sophie, and they are childhood besties. The two of them, for their own respective reasons, have to get in a marriage of convenience. So Sophie lives in the small town that they grew up in. She owns I believe a bed and breakfast, or like an inn of some sort, and this is like her main passion in life. Like, she just wants to be in her small town running this inn. She's always wanted to do that. And so Holden comes back in town to help his grandfather with their vet business that's in town. His grandpa's gonna take some time off, and so Holden's gonna step in and be the vet while he's on vacation. But Holden does not want to stay in a small town. That is not his goal in life. He is only there to help his grandpa out for a short amount of time. So they both need a marriage and convenience for their own reasons that will help them with their future careers. And so they get fake married. Like, they're totally fine with it. They're like, we're friends. It's fine, we can pretend to be married, whatever, it's fine. But then they start sparking real feelings between each other that they did not know were there. And so things get a lot complicated when they start realizing that they have feelings for each other, like deep feelings, but they both have their separate lives that they're going to. Like, Holden does not want to stay in a small town, and Sophie is never leaving it. So they're finding it very difficult to be together when they actually start liking each other and falling for each other, when they know that, like, they are in each other's way of their dream. I really loved this. This is a great, like, small town foodie, like, just cozy vibe romance. The friends to lovers part was really sweet too, like the familial part. I love their families and how they knew each other and loved each other. Like, this was so sweet. Next, I have a holiday one. This is Wrapped Up in You by Talia Hibbert. I will mention a Talia Hibbert at whatever chance I can get, even if it's a Christmas romance and it's already past Christmas, okay? This is the romance between William and Abby, who are childhood best friends. So William is actually best friends with Abby and her brother, and they were next door neighbors growing up, but William did not have the best home life, and so he would spend a lot of time at Abby and her brother's home. He would spend holidays with them. So it's a tradition for William to come to Abby and her brother's grandmother's home every year for Christmas. So they're all grown up now. They're all adults. They've been doing this for years. And so this year for Christmas, when he's going to go over to Abby's grandmother's house, he has decided he's finally going to tell the woman of his dreams that he's been in love with her for years. However, Abby does not believe him when he reveals his feelings. She's like, what? You're lying. You're making fun of me. No, because Abby has been in love with William for years. But William is a very, very, very popular Hollywood actor right now. This book takes place in Britain, but he moved to the States to get a certain role in a movie. And he's kind of like, if you can look by the cover, he's very Chris Evans, Chris Hemsworth type of actor. And so she's baffled that this guy that she's been crushing on for years actually likes her. This one was so cute and sweet. It made me laugh so hard. Tully Hibbert's writing is just fantastic. And her meddlesome family members, her grandmother, A plus. And her grandmother knew this whole time, like, they're going to get together. It's going to happen. So I'm just waiting for it. I'm gonna finagle some things to push them together. This is just incredibly sweet and incredibly cute and a wonderful holiday read. Next, I have an interesting one. So this is Caught by the Convicts by Jessica Kane. Yeah, but Jessica Kane, okay? Jessica Kane writes some pretty unhinged novellas, just FYI. And this is interesting because going into this book, I did not know that this is an MMF romance. I thought it was an MFM. So if you don't know, so the difference between MFM and MMF, sorry, that's a lot of letters. Okay, so MMF romances where the M's touch in like the statement mean that the guys touch as well. So the guys are together. So MFMs, the guys are separate with the F in between them. So the guys are not together. So this is an MMF. So the guys are friends. And this is the friends to lovers part in here. So Wendy is our heroine in here. She decides to go to her town penitentiary to make sure that her father's actually behind bars. He's tormented her all her life and she just can't wrap her brain around him actually being in jail. Like, she doesn't believe it, so she needs to see it with her eyes. When she's at jail, there's an unexpected jailbreak. So two men who share a cell together end up seeing Wendy and take her into their cell to protect her, but also to get with her. So the two guys that are in the cell, they are best friends, and it's not until this woman is introduced to them that they realize that they have also been having feelings for each other. And so it's a friends to lovers romance between the two of them, and then they rope the heroine in with them as well. And so they have fun together in the cell, but then also try and spring a little jailbreak to get out of the cell to be with her. This one is wild and it's crazy, but it is a grand good old time. For a historical romance, I have It's in His Kiss by Julia Quinn. This is book number 7 in the Bridgerton series, one of the only Bridgerton books that I actually did enjoy. This is the romance between Gareth and Hyacinth. So if you've read the Bridgerton books or watched the show, Lady Danbury has a grandson, and this is her grandson named Gareth. And Hyacinth Bridgerton is actually kind of like the close companion to Lady Danbury, which I'm so excited for that relationship in the show to see that. So they've gotten quite close, and Gareth and Hyacinth are kind of like forced into being in the same room together or certain situations because she is so close with his grandmother. Gareth ends up spilling the beans that he's trying to find a certain item, and it can only be found by translating this certain text that's written in Italian. Hyacinth just so happens to speak Italian, and she tries to help him translate the text and find the lost item he's trying to find. Throughout all of this, they become like their best friends. Like, they are each other's everything, each other's world. And they are so close. Like, at first, it's not romantic whatsoever. They're like, you're my best friend. I love you as a friend. I will do everything with you. Like, they are besties. Then something happens, something shifts, and Gareth starts to see Hyacinth in a totally different way. And he's like, she is the love of my life. She's my best friend and the love of my life, and I can't live without her. And it was so sweet. I don't see a lot of historical friends to lovers romances, so this was such an enjoyable read for me. For a fantasy romance, I have A Touch of Stone and Snow by Mila Vane. I just adore Mila Vane and all of her works. She's only written 2, I think. but her fantasy romances are absolutely epic and amazing. Amazing works of art in my head. This is the romance between Lizen and Arax. So they were childhood friends. They lived in this village together. They did everything together. They were best friends. And then they slowly started to grow into something more. And they started to realize, this is my person. This is my forever person. I'm going to be with them for the rest of my life. Like, they quickly realize like they are saving themselves for each other because they know that they're going to be together, and they both know this about each other. Until one day something happens to Lizen. So she goes on a mission with a bunch of other warriors and people, and she is the lone survivor of the battle on her side. And she has a scar over her face now, and people think that she is cursed, and she abandoned their people and deserted them. And so she gets cast out by the surviving people in the village, and she has not been seen in quite a long time. Arax is absolutely devastated. He's like, that's my best friend. That's my fated person. Like, he is devastated that she's gone, and he is tasked to do something and thinks that Lizen can help him. And so he goes on track to try and find her to help him with this task. And when they're together again, feelings arise between them all over. They start to realize like they never stopped loving each other, even though she was outcasted from their people. There's so much more in this too. Arax has an adorable, cute and sweet, but deadly snow leopard that's like his best friend that absolutely loves Lizen. This fantasy romance and this series in general is just something you totally need to read if you have not yet. I of course have two Ruby Dixons I have to mention. First is Barbarian's Prize by Ruby Dixon. It just came out with a new cover. Look at it, it's stunning. This is the romance between Tiffany and Saluk. This is book number 6 in the series. Technically book 5. I kind of count her holiday book as book 5, but a lot of people count that as like a in-between or novella, but you know what, it's okay. On Goodreads, it says it's book number 5. This is Tiffany, who was in the first round of alien crashers, human crashers on the planet Nahoth. And she is one of the only human women, I think there's like her and like Josie left, who has not had resonance, which is like something that happens to you where you find your fated mate on this planet with aliens. And so she's one of the only few women who has not had a fated mate, and she's kind of sad. She's like, why hasn't this happened to me? Like, what is going on? But she's also kind of happy because she doesn't want to be put in like a situation she's forced into, and she thinks that something like this could be forced. She's not really into all of these alien men fawning over her and wanting to be her mate. She just wants to be alone and not have that kind of attention. And so Saluk here is trying to be her friend. He just wants her to be his friend, and they really bond over her love of plants and gardening, and she tries to grow plants on the planet that the humans can eat, and Saluk helps her with that, and they just become the bestest of friends. And it isn't until after that relationship has developed do they start developing romantic feelings for each other, even before the resonance bond happens. So I love this one in the IPV series, and I want more people to read this one because a lot of people stop reading the series before they get to this one, and it's such a shame because I love Tiffany and Saluk. And lastly, I really want to mention a recent favorite of mine, which is When She's Lonely. This is one of her later books, one of her most recent books in her Rizdiverse series, which are standalone alien novellas that you can totally read on their own. They're just like the only commonality, like side characters do pop up in this series, but the only commonality is it all takes place on the same planet, which is like a human refugee planet called Rizda 3, where human women who have been illegally abducted can come to Rizda 3 to live normal, sustaining lives. So this is the romance between Ashley and Kex, and their relationship at first isn't the greatest, because Kex thinks that Ashley is very rude, like a very rude human woman who isn't the nicest, when in actuality he does not know that Ashley is hard of hearing, and when she was abducted from Earth, she was not taken with her hearing aids. And so when she was first abducted, she was basically told by alien slavers, because she was a human slave, like, if you are an imperfect slave, you are unalived, like, you know. And so she tries to fake it till she makes it, basically, and pretend that she is able to hear. She can, I think, hear partially out of one ear, and she is deaf in one. Like, so when people stand on one side of her, she can't hear them. And so they're talking, asking her something, and she's ignoring them. And they, like, that's what they think, that she's just ignoring them, when in actuality, she just can't hear them. So Kex soon realizes, like, Ashley isn't mean or rude or, like, ignoring people. She just can't hear them. Like, he realizes this on his own. And it's really funny, so Ashley doesn't want people to know this because it has like a deep implanted seed in her brain. Like, oh, if someone finds out I'm imperfect, I will die. Even though she's on this like refugee planet now, she's completely safe. The thought has still not escaped her. Like, she still thinks that evil aliens can come back and take her. So she's trying to still keep this a secret. So Kex realizes on his own that she's hard of hearing, and he kind of blackmails her. He's like, okay, I realize this, but you know what? I'm not gonna tell anybody if you agree to go on some dates with me and like just hang out with me. And because he realizes that she's very lonely, she doesn't have any friends. Kex doesn't really have many friends either. And so he sees this as a perfect opportunity to get to know this woman and become friends with her. They become each other's best friends in every single way possible, and it is so incredibly sweet. They fall in love on page, and it is beautiful. I love this friends to lovers romance so much. This is such an underrated Ruby book that is fantastic. It's also own voices because Ruby is hard of hearing herself and she uses hearing aids also. And so I just love that aspect of the book. Anyways, there you have it. Those were some friends to lovers romance recommendations for you. Please let me know down below if you've read any of these books or if you plan to. And if you don't feel like commenting any of those things, you can leave me the cat emoji in the comment section down below because he has a snow leopard cat pet. Anyways, thank y'all so much for watching. I will see y'all soon in my next one. Bye, y'all.